Paying for an International Education, The Myanmar Times, written by Aung Zin Phyo Thein, published on 27th May 2013. I recently came across a ludicrous article. I won't reveal the title and author, but it was a scathing attack on the rapidly increasing number of international schools in Myanmar. Despite being well-written, it focused mainly on criticizing the lack of foreign teachers. The article stated emphatically that owing to a lack of qualified foreign teachers, our children are exposed to bad education. I read it again, made a cutting, and placed it in a personal album titled Published Nonsense. I did agree with one thing. Most international schools in Myanmar are not up to an international standard. In liberalizing different aspects of our society, we have enjoyed some gains, yet incurred some losses as well. The private education sector is one of these losses. International schools are sprouting like mushrooms. They are massive investments, trying to outdo one another with glossy advertisements. Billboards all over Yangon are full of summer courses, special discounts, and other promotional campaigns. The word international, in my opinion, is too easily and loosely employed. The beaming faces of smartly uniformed pupils in advertisements on billboards, newspapers, and television are hiding a sinister truth. As businesses, these schools are striving for one golden goal: profit. This is not a bad thing, provided that the schools fulfill their promise of a sound education with an internationally recognized and accredited curriculum, and, most importantly, qualified, dedicated teaching specialists. A school stocked with an eclectic mix of Caucasian teachers isn't the answer. A white face doesn't always translate into proper teaching. In truth, as many Myanmar parents are beginning to discover, it is very much the opposite. These teachers can be classified into two groups: those with proper qualifications and experience, and those whom I call carpetbaggers. Backpacking foreigners with little or no prior experience or dubious backgrounds have come barging into Myanmar and declared themselves teachers, usually of English, mathematics, or art. Why are they hired? Because they are cheap, relative to the cost of an experienced, qualified professional who can seek a teaching post anywhere in the world. Some of these teachers are more at home in a bar in downtown Yangon than a classroom. Unfortunately, high school fees does not equal high-quality instruction. It is a case of buyer beware. Parents are buying an education, and as consumers, should not be afraid to demand quality in return. Based on my experience and the experiences of many of my friends, there is also a frequent absence of properly trained auxiliary staff and administrators who know how to run an international school. In short, many of the staff at these schools are learning on the job at the expense of our students. There is also the question of proper accreditation. If a school decides to follow, for example, the American Advanced Placement System, has the school achieved full accreditation? Is it subject to checkups from the governing international education bodies, such as the Western Association of Schools and Colleges, or the European Council for International Schools, which both demand high standards from members and carry out regular inspections? Unless proper background checks and changes to industry practices are implemented by both the government and the schools, standards in the sector are likely to plummet. In my opinion, the government should issue licenses to foreign teachers only after conducting background checks on their identity, qualifications, teaching experience, and health and criminal records. Other countries, such as China and some in the Middle East, enforce similar standards. Schools should conduct surveys of students to gauge the performance of their teachers and publish final examination results along with a list of teachers and their credentials. Our Myanmar students deserve the best, not merely token Caucasians who can't find work elsewhere. Parents are spending a great deal of money and putting a lot of trust in these schools for the sake of their children. Many are not wealthy and are working in the maritime industry, for example, or sending money home from abroad to support their children's schooling. Every parent wants his or her child to lead a better, more educated life than they had. This is a goal that should be honored by the institutions concerned. On their shoulders rest the well-being of not only families and individuals, but also the nation. Aung Zin Phyo Thein was 17 years old when he wrote this article. He studied at the Diplomatic School of Yangon from kindergarten to grade 10, and then attended the International Baccalaureate Program at Horizon International School. After his second year at Horizon, he studied international relations at Durham University in Durham, England. He is now studying for his master's in public policy at the University of Nottingham.